Just look at that glorious old school railway signal behind me. Today, we're here in Bowness, and we're going to go on the Bowness to Kinneil Heritage Railway. That means we're going on a steam train. Okay, let's go and have a look inside the station. I love the bunting. I'm loving these old school railway buildings already. Oh, I love those lamps. They're almost like Narnia lamps, aren't they? And the old railway wagons. So the steam trains on the Bowness to Kinneil Railway run every weekend on Saturdays and Sundays and selected days during the week. So you have to check in advance. And most days there's about two or three return journeys from here in Bowness to Kinneil and back. And the interesting thing is that they have to switch the locomotive from the front of the train to the back of the train at each end. And that's the part of the journey which I'm going to be really fascinated by. And just look at that absolutely glorious signal box. That is beautiful. I'm getting all sorts of childhood memories about my Hornby railway set. I had a signal box just like that one. Oh my goodness, the gentleman in the signal box has just invited me to go up and see him. How are you doing?
Well, just go up.
Thanks you. Oh, this is exciting, isn't it? Oh my goodness, the signal box. Just look at all of those levers. This really is retro. This white one?
Yeah.
Shall I pull it?
You pull it, aye.
Ah, what did that do?
Nothing.
Nothing! I better put it back then. Oh, that was so cool. That was so cool. It's absolutely made my day going into that signal box. The signalman was called Donald, so thanks, Donald. That was fantastic. Well, I'm booked on the train at 12:30. It's about 25 to 12 now, and the inbound train is just about to arrive. So let's get our first glimpse of today's steam locomotive. Here's our locomotive for today, just taking on some water. Once they've finished refilling the water tank, this steam train is going to go all the way to the other end of the carriages, and then they'll switch the points so that it can come in and lock onto the front of the train, and that's what's going to take us to Kinneil. I think we should go up onto the footbridge so that we can see the steam train come along and then switch to go back to couple up with the carriages. What do you think? Let's go. And here it comes back on the correct track to couple up with the train. I should have said, there's an extensive railway museum here at the Bowness and Kinneil Railway as well. So after we've done our little journey, we're going to head into the museum to see lots of old school trains. So do stick around till later in the video. Let's have a closer look at the loco. I'm definitely getting Thomas the Tank Engine vibes from this one. Let's just have a quick look inside the cab. Oh, look at the fire down there. Well, I'm in coach C today. Let's go and get on board. Some of these carriages look like they're set out for tea. This is so exciting. Look at this old school railway carriage. Coach C, this is our ride. Let's check out the old school first class cabins first, shall we? Oh, it's a bit dark. But take a look at this. Ooh. If you really want to push the boat out with your visit to the Bowness and Kinneil Railway, you can book one of these first class cabins. 60 quid, but there are six seats, six comfortable seats, so get yourself a group of friends together, come and have a party. I paid £13 for my standard class seat. Let's go have a look. So is this an upgrade or a downgrade to an LNER Azuma? I'm not going to do a seat review like I do in most of my travel videos, but I have to say, that's about the bounciest train seat I've ever sat on. One thing I have noticed is, look how the seats are completely and utterly flush with the windows in this carriage. Modern train designers take note. How many trains have you been on where the seats don't line up with the windows? This is a plus for the old school style train. If you listen very carefully, you can hear the sound of the pistons on the steam engine and the occasional toot of the horn. Keep getting a glimpse of billowing clouds of smoke coming down over the carriages, and of course you can smell the smoke. We've got really fast just before, and I could hear a chuff, 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 chuff of the steam engine. This is just fabulous. Well, here we are at the end of the line at Manuel. I was actually wrong before. The train goes from Bowness to here, which is Manuel. Kinneil was actually a stop along the way, but doesn't matter, we're here anyway. We're going to be here for about 25 minutes as they switch the loco. So just as before, they've got to take the locomotive from the front of the train and around to the back so that it can pull us all the way back to Bowness. Just grown men playing with gigantic toys, isn't it? Okay, let's get back on board. We're heading back to Bowness, and then we're going to go around the museum. Don't forget, stick around. Let's see what trains we can see in the museum. That was torrential rain for a few moments, but it does seem to be clearing up again as we arrive back at Bowness Station. Welcome back to a very wet Bowness, but thank you to Thomas for getting us home. That was such great fun. So, we've just come over the footbridge, we're heading into the museum. Let's go and see what treasures we can find. Welcome to the Museum of Scottish Railways, apparently Scotland's largest railway museum. I know there'll be steam trains, but I also know that there's an old Caledonian sleeper carriage and an old LNER locomotive, so trains of all sorts. Look at this thing. You wouldn't want to be on the receiving end of that thing, would you? Quite up to date to start with. That is the Class 91 locomotive that powered the last generation of LNER trains. You never get as close as this to trains in train stations. Feel the power of history. We can change the points. And right next to the LNER train, look at this absolute beauty. Absolutely magnificent. This is called the Gordon Highlander. And this is one of the carriages conveyed by the Gordon Highlander. Let's have a look inside. Oh, look at that. It's like being inside somebody's parlour rather than inside a train carriage. Actually, there's more history in this one than the other one, I think. They've even got the signs from train stations. Look, Manuel, that's where we were earlier. Culloden Moor. Caledonian sleeper. That's one of the old-style Caledonian sleeper carriages. In fact, I did a vlog about 5 years ago. It could have been in that very carriage. That steam train's called Maud. Ever fancied seeing inside a mail train? And letters. And it's not just locomotives and passenger carriages, they've got all sorts of vans and wagons here as well. Coal, anybody? Leith General Warehousing. This is shunting locomotive number 42, built in 1887, just a few years before the fourth rail bridge opened. I wonder whether this one ever went over the top. Inside the shunting locomotive. Ooh. Oh, that's a hard lever to pull. I'm sure I had this Saxasalt wagon in my Hornby train set. This is a Glasgow Underground train from 1901. That's incredible, isn't it? And we can go inside this one. Oh my goodness. Look at these seats. That's really bouncy. That really does support my theory that as trains have got more sleek and more modern, the seats have got harder and more uncomfortable. The Glasgow Subway is the only underground system in the world that has never expanded beyond its original layout. Oh, look at that. Fabulous old diesel train. Now, I know it looks like some of this rolling stock is in a really dilapidated state, but there is an active workshop here. Day in, day out, they're renovating some of these classic old museum pieces. Just before, I was walking past and I could see somebody welding away. So they're doing their best to renovate these glorious old wagons. Haha, someone's got a sense of humour. Bowness Depot, no admittance except on business. No train spotters either. Seriously though, everybody here at the Bowness and Kinneil Railway and Museum absolutely adore trains. You can tell it's in the service that they provide. Everybody is just so enthusiastic about the railways. Wow, there's so much to see. I've been walking around that museum now for a good hour and a half, and I've only just scratched the surface of what there is to see. Well, what can I say? That was an absolutely perfect day out. Perfect if you're a train geek like me. Perfect, though, for families as well. The youngsters will absolutely love it here, especially if, like me, they got to ride with Thomas the Tank Engine. I cannot recommend the Bowness and Kinneil Railway and Museum highly enough. It really is fantastic. And actually, it's a full day out. I've been here for nearly 6 hours. There's that much to see. So highly recommended. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Rog Vlog. If you enjoyed the video, please do subscribe to the YouTube channel. Until the next video, remember, there's always something to see. So get out there and find it. Just let go.